Wednesday is the big day for millions of Social Security beneficiaries. I have all the details and further clarification for you in this video, so let's get into it right now. But if you haven't done so, or if you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button right down below the video so you can join the fastest growing advocacy group and the number one channel right here on YouTube dedicated to bringing you daily updates as it pertains to low income, fixed income, Social Security, SSDI, SSI, VA, RRB, money, benefits, and so much more that we're covering in these videos every single day throughout this incredibly confusing time. So again, thank you so much for joining me. I'm right here by your side every single day, helping you navigate this very difficult time, and I want to do whatever I possibly can to make sure that you're getting all of the money and anything else we can possibly get right now as things are changing very rapidly. So again, make sure to subscribe by hitting the button right down below the video. It's totally free, and let's get into this right now. And yes, my wife Corey will be back in just a couple minutes here with the newest updated list of shoutouts for those names pulled right out of the fan club. So congratulations in advance. Make sure to stay tuned to see if your name will be called for a shoutout in this video. And by the way, it does change every single video right here on the channel. All right, so let's get into this right now. So Wednesday is going to be a big day that many millions of Social Security beneficiaries have been waiting for a very long time. So I want to talk about what Wednesday actually means, and then I also want to offer some clarification as I continue to see a lot of comments and questions down below over the last couple days and the last week or so here on the channel, and I want to offer some clarification about this because it seems that there may have been some changes, but realistically, not a whole lot has changed. So I want to offer some clarification on this just because I do know that the vast majority of the community here are those of you receiving benefits, like I mentioned, Social Security, SSDI, SSI, VA, RRB, a lot of low income, fixed income. So I want to offer some clarification on this because it's confusing. Seriously, things continue to change. There's so many changes right now. It's like hard to keep up with everything going on sometimes, right? But don't worry, that's why I'm here for you every single day. So Wednesday will be the day that millions of Social Security beneficiaries will be getting their new higher benefit as a result of 2022. Now, these first payments that are going to be, well, let me take that back. It's technically not even the first round of payments that have gone out. Some of you received your payments back on December 30th. Those would have been from SSI beneficiaries, which we all know is not technically Social Security, but rather SSI, Supplemental Security Income, is administered by the Social Security Administration, but yet it's not Social Security benefits. However, some of you down in the comments section, I've also been noticing, received your benefits on January 3rd. Amazing, right? That's awesome. I've seen a lot of comments saying, hey, I received my benefits on the 3rd. I'm all good, right? Yeah, that's awesome, right? That's very exciting. However, the next big wave of payments will be going out this Wednesday, which is January 12th, and that is going to be a very big and exciting day for a lot of people. Now, here's what these benefits are going to be doing and who these benefits will be going out to on Wednesday. These are for the people who have a birthday that lands between January 1st and, well, sorry, let me take that back. Anywhere between the 1st of the month and the 10th of the month, not necessarily January, right? But if you have a birthday that lands anywhere between the 1st and the 10th of the month, your benefits will be distributed this coming Wednesday. Now, there are some different stipulations and some different parameters around that. Yes, you may have already received your benefits on the 3rd of the month, but in general, for those of you that have been receiving Social Security benefits for a while now, or if you're a new recipient of Social Security, and yes, this does include retirement, disability, SSDI, and survivor's benefits, you'd likely be getting your benefits this coming Wednesday, the 12th. So Social Security generally distributes their payments on Wednesdays, right? Each Wednesday of the month. Well, technically it's not each Wednesday. It's the second Wednesday, the third Wednesday, and the fourth Wednesdays of the month. So it totally depends on when your birthday lands in the month, right? So like I said, if your birthday is between the 1st and the 10th of the month, you should be getting your payment this coming Wednesday, the 12th. Now remember, that is if you get direct deposit. If you get it into a direct express account, if you get it into a bank account, a checking or a savings account, but if you receive a paper check that is delivered to you, please just remember that could take a little bit longer. Now let's quickly talk about a little bit more clarification on what is going on here and what this all means. means as far as why are we kind of looking at this payment and why is this one kind of exciting. Here's the deal. This is your first higher payment as a result of the cost of living adjustment. Now, we do know that here in 2022 that everybody is going to be receiving that 5.9% higher benefit as a result of the COLA raise that was announced back in mid-October by the Social Security Administration. So that is automatically applied to your benefit. Now, I've also seen some comments down below over the last week or so, some of you saying, I didn't get my higher benefit. Why not? Well, as I said previously, and again too, you might want to wait a little while. If you've already received your monthly benefit and it did not include the raise, you may want to call on that and just ask what the deal is, because everybody should have received the 5.9% cost of living adjustment, including retirement benefits, Social Security retirement, SSDI, survivors, SSI, and VA beneficiaries. All of you should have received a 5.9% cost of living adjustment. So you should be getting that. If it's not there, you might want to give the Social Security Administration a call and ask them what's going on. Why didn't I get my benefit? Here's typically what happens with these COLA raises. Usually that comes in and it's added right onto your benefit, right? So it's usually right there in your benefit. However, sometimes if your income is increased, you know, to a certain level, sometimes they'll maybe reduce other benefits like SNAP benefits, maybe rental assistance, maybe utility assistance, maybe some kind of other assistance that you may be receiving could potentially be reduced as a result of your higher benefit because of the COLA raise, right? That's what everybody loves, right? We love getting our benefits reduced when we get a little raise. Yeah, pretty typical. However, there is maybe an instance or two where it may look like you didn't get your raise, but really it is actually there. And that could be if your benefit is a little bit smaller. And the reason for that is the COLA raise would come in, but then as we know, the massive Medicare Part B premium increase for 2022, a whopping $21 more than it was last year, could potentially reduce your entire COLA raise, pretty much making it look like you didn't get a raise at all, when in fact it could actually be there, but rather it's just all being eaten up by the Medicare Part B premium increase. So does that make kind of sense? So that's what could be happening there for those of you that have been looking at your benefit and saying, I didn't get the raise. Well, we'd have to dig a little bit deeper and maybe it is actually there, but rather it's all just being reduced by the Medicare Part B premium. I hope that makes sense. All right, so let's quickly talk through a little bit more and offer a little bit more clarification on this, because I've seen this popping up down in the comment section quite a bit here over the last week or so, and I want to talk about this a little further. So I've seen a lot of questions coming out asking, will I be getting another benefit, another payment on the 12th of January? Here's what I can say to that. If you've already received your benefit on maybe December 30th because of SSI, Supplemental Security Income, maybe you received it on the 3rd of the month, and again, that could be from all benefits, right? If you already received your benefit for January, then I'm gonna say no, you're not gonna get another benefit on January 12th. This is just for those people who historically get their benefit on the second Wednesday of the month. So if you previously were getting your benefit on the second Wednesday of the month, then that's when you're going to continue to get it. And that second Wednesday of the month is this Wednesday, January 12th. So that's why I'm saying if you've been getting it that day, you're likely going to continue receiving it that day. So it does not mean that another benefit is going to be arriving that day, but rather that's the day that if you've been getting it the second Wednesday of the month, then you'll continue getting it the second Wednesday of the month. So I hope that offers a little bit more clarification. So yeah, there's been a lot of changes recently, but for the most part, when it comes to payment dates for Social Security beneficiaries, retirement, SSDI, survivors, even SSI, that should all be remaining the same and there shouldn't be any major changes there. Of course, unless you have something specific to your account, but for the vast majority of people, nothing should be changing there, right? It should all be the exact same thing as we've all been seeing for many, many years. So there shouldn't be really any major changes there. Now, this week as well will be a big week as we're going to be getting more details on those couple new stimulus packages that were proposed just last week. So a couple days ago, late last week, we did get those two stimulus packages, brand new packages that were talked about, that were introduced, and we should be getting a lot more details this week on both of those packages. And of course, we'll be watching very closely to see what might be in these packages that any of us receiving these fixed income benefits, you know, that I've been mentioning throughout this video, should actually be getting something out of these packages. Now, if there's anything in the packages, of course, I'll be right here to let you know what is in them and what we can get our hands on. Or if there's nothing, of course, I'll keep you updated there as well. But please remember, this is the simple framework of these bills. We don't know all the details yet, and according to what it looks like they still want to continue working on these packages and continue to kind of fine-tune them a little bit as they continue to move forward over the coming days. However, I would anticipate we're probably going to be getting some big updates this week as well on those packages, and potentially even the official announcement out of the president calling on Congress to bring that package as soon as possible. Remember, because late last week, all we heard was the president was going to be coming to Congress asking them to actually distribute another stimulus package. However, he didn't ask yet. I have not seen anything official yet come out say that, okay, the president has addressed Congress asking for the additional stimulus package. I've not seen an official ask from the president yet, but rather it was said that the president would be coming out asking for that. So hopefully there'll be something in there in either of these two packages for fixed income beneficiaries of Social Security, SSDI, SSI, VA, RRB, low income, no income, everybody that we talk about right here in the videos every single day. And one quick side note also, if you're somebody who receives SSI, again, your benefit will continue to arrive on the same day that it always does. I could always drop a payment calendar somewhere also, but basically it's the same thing. If you're receiving SSI, your payment dates are always the first of the month, unless the first of the month lands on a weekend or a holiday, which doesn't happen all that often, New Year's Day, right? And then you would receive it the Friday before if it lands on a holiday. However, what was weird too is for the first payment this year, I saw a number of comments, many people reaching out saying, hey, I got a pending payment on New Year's Day. Weird. I've never seen it penned on a holiday, and I've never seen it penned on a weekend. So who knows? Maybe they made some changes this year, and maybe that was their New Year's resolution to start pending payments on weekends and holidays. I doubt it, but you never know, right? But kind of interesting, as I saw a number of you reaching out saying, I've never seen this before, but I have a pending payment and it's the weekend. So that was kind of interesting to see that a week or so ago, a little over a week ago. So I hope this helps you out. Again, Wednesday, watch for it. If you're somebody who receives your payments as a direct deposit onto your Direct Express card or possibly into a bank account, watch it, because you will be getting your higher benefit, and you should have received that letter from Social Security about 3-4 weeks ago or so, and that would have laid out exactly how much your benefit is going to be. Otherwise, just continue watching your account and it'll hit. And if you do receive Direct Express, again, it could start pending a day or two before your actual payment hits and actually deposits into your account. So hope this helps you out. Again, I've had a lot of questions on this. Wanted to clarify a little bit for you, let you know what Wednesday actually means. And that is the day that millions of beneficiaries will be getting their payments, followed up by the next wave of payments going out shortly thereafter. So hope this helps you. Again, please make sure to hit that subscribe button right down below the video. It's totally free to do so. Also, share this video or go back and check out any of the other 2,000 videos right here on the channel. And with that being said, Corey, my wife, will be in right here right now to read the new updated list of shoutouts for those of you pulled right out of the fan club. Thank you so much for being part of the fan club, by the way. It is completely optional. It is not required by any means at all. All of the videos here on the channel are free, 100% free, always have been and always will be going forward. But the fan club is just for those people who want maybe a little bit more, or if you want to join the list for daily shoutouts. So there's a link down below in the description if you're interested in checking it out. Otherwise, at the top of the comments section as well, there will be a pinned comment there from me with a link. So Corey, take it away. Congratulations to all of the fan club winners right here for the shoutouts in today's video. Corey, take it away.
We're excited to shout out James Pitts, Tanya Little, Karen Gray, Donna Frank, Gwendolyn Singleton, and David Murray. Thank you for being in the fan club.